Mr. Billy Burnette.
How you doing, Rich?
Thank you for being here, my friend.
Thank you for having me.
You had your first recording session as an artist at 7 years old.
Yeah, I was signed to Dot Records. In fact, I did a Christmas record with the Rick Nelson Band.
And so you're born in Memphis, and you're one of seven.
One of seven. Oldest of seven.
God bless your mom. Yeah. You've lived in all these cultural epicenters for music. You're from Memphis. What a rich tradition there. You were in Los Angeles in the heydays, in the 80s and 90s.
That was really a paradise and really a wonderful place to be.
Before it became too saturated and overcrowded.
Yeah, now it's like too crowded.
It's so crowded.
Nashville's too crowded. You know what? I didn't pick up the guitar till I was a teenager, actually.
So what, were you just singing?
I was just singing, yeah.
Singing melodies.
I just sang and I did the... I had a few moves, you know. I went on the road with Brenda Lee when I was 13.
And your relationship with Fleetwood Mac, you were in many incarnations of the band.
I joined in 87.
Wow.
To take Lindsey's place. Mm-hmm. And Rick Vito joined with me. Great guitar player. And I just kind of was a fan.
Right.
So I was in the band and I'd start working with Christine McVie. And with Stevie, I did a duet with Stevie before I joined the band. So I was already in the kind of family. And I'd sang on a couple of Fleetwood Mac records at the time.
And I really like this story that you have, this business model of yours, which is you've always functioned as a recording artist in your own right.
Yeah.
You've always been in bands, writing multi-genre music for pop stars, rock stars, and country stars.
Yeah.
And that's a great model because people are like, you just got to pick a lane, do one thing. I feel like you were way ahead of the curve because nowadays you have to do everything just to survive.
Yeah, we've all reinvented ourselves, so to speak.
Right. And I'm a newlywed and I get my wife a cat and I say, this is your new friend because, yeah. I mean, I'm so glad that we had this great honeymoon and now this is your new friend. And then I laughed. How can we expect our partners to put up with that?
With Fleetwood Mac, we used to have a family week where we'd bring out the family for a week.
Oh, my God.
It was 3 months on, 10 days off.
That's great. Am I crazy? Do you guys get the gas for your teeth? You know,
I do.
The laughing gas?
I have to have a gas.
I have to have.
For a teeth cleaning?
Old school, man.
Oh, that's like... to me, that's kind of painful when they're poking around your mouth.
Yeah, like that, you know? And then you're envisioning what's going on in there. When you get the gas, it's just like you're just dreaming of some other place.
I got a cavity filled without Novocaine on.
Oh, be crazy.
Really? Yeah. Without?
Yeah. During that, you know,
no, thanks. No. Yeah. you gotta drug me, guys. You know when Rambo's doing surgery on himself in the jungle?
Yeah.
That would never be me.
Oh, yeah.
Subscribe. Rate and follow along at richredmond.com/podcasts.